Cincinnati's track record for solving murders is not making the grade right now.
No, certainly is not. Compared to a little earlier this year, we have really seen a definite drop-off in the number of investigations ending in arrest. WLWT News 5's John London live now with a look at what investigators are saying about all of this tonight. John?
Well, Cherie, they're saying these investigations don't run on autopilot, that it takes painstaking investigative work that sometimes produces the necessary evidence and sometimes does not. She doesn't like to linger in this lot.
Just the memories that nobody won't forget.
Amy Thompson would rather focus on the weather-battered memorials to her murdered brother, Brian Thompson, who was shot almost a year ago in his car right outside his home along Store Street in Lower Price Hill.
This is actually the spot where he got killed. His house is over here. He was pulling up from the store and he pulled up here. And that's where it happened.
Someone had ripped off a dice game that night in the alley where we walked. Retaliation followed. Two people were shot. That's when her 27-year-old brother unwittingly arrived to a chaotic scene.
And they needed a ride out of here, so I guess he didn't move fast enough, and they just said, screw it, and shot him. They didn't even give him a chance to try to get out or explain or anything.
His death remains one of Cincinnati's unsolved killings. Last year, 6 out of every 10 homicides in the city were cleared by an arrest. So far this year, the clearance rate is 3 out of every 10.
If they're not solved, that doesn't mean they're not going to be solved here in the near future. So there are some things in the pipeline.
Lieutenant Colonel Bailey, moments after a review of the violent crime stats.
A lot of cases, we know that there were people right there that saw this happen.
Amy says there were dozens of people in the street at the time her brother was shot dead. At mid-afternoon today, it was teeming with activity.
You know, like the dice game, they should have never been there playing dice.
She says somebody in the neighborhood should have reported them. The makeshift RIP memorials that pockmarked the city symbolize the recent spike in shootings and killings, even though overall crime is lower.
The guys over there are working as hard as ever to try to, you know, identify who's responsible for these things.
And here at District 1, a few hours ago, they made another block-by-block review of the violent crime statistics this year. Even at a 31% clearance rate, the Cincinnati clearance rate exceeds the national average. Live at District 1, John London, WLWT News 5.
And as John was showing you right there, in the past 3 weeks, there has been a definite increase in gun violence in the city of Cincinnati, at least 2 dozen shootings and 6 homicides.